I was actually in the west part because I escaped like 6 months before the wall came down. I was on the other side, and I watched also by accident the show where Chapovsky said like the wall's open, everyone in East Germany can travel. So I went down to a checkpoint to the border on Chausseestrasse in Berlin, and I was like hopping back and forward because I was afraid that I couldn't get back in. So it was a really special moment. It was just by myself, and I just felt really like, wow. I mean, like being like in growing up in East Germany, it wasn't a big problem for me, you know, because as a child you just felt really protected, you know. But when you started to become more curious about things, then all of a sudden all the problems started, because you know, you realized, you know, you're in jail. You know, there's certain things you couldn't ask, and there's certain trouble you got into. And that was a time where, for me, I felt like, wow, I can't breathe anymore. I played with, like, a lot of bands, you know, I made music, but it was no... I mean, you always had to be underground, you know, there was two ways, the underground way, and then you know, the other way was to have to study, and you had to make, like, a profession out of music. You know, but it doesn't work in music, especially in rock. It's all about emotions, all about, like, you know, feelings you have. So, obviously, they really try to push those emotions down. Without the wall coming down, Rammstein would never happen. You know, I mean, there's a lot of changes in my life. But I still, like, be grateful about, like, living in both situations, you know. I don't regret anything.